I'm Dr. Marina Keller. I'm an infectious disease expert here at Middletown Medical, where we're committed in helping you be informed about best practices in dealing with the coronavirus. Coronavirus is a respiratory virus, which means it attacks your lungs. It's a lot like the flu. So when somebody coughs or sneezes, what's coming out of their nose or their mouth can travel and land on you. And the virus is in that, that saliva or whatever's coming out of their nose, and can infect you. So we want to encourage you to do common sense best practice. So if you cough or you sneeze, you don't know if you have coronavirus or the flu or any other respiratory infection. So you should cover your cough and your sneeze every time. Either cough into your arm or use a tissue, throw the tissue out. That way you prevent the spread of any infection, especially coronavirus. I want to remind you of how to appropriately wash your hands to prevent getting corona. If somebody does sneeze or cough over you and they didn't cover their sneeze or cough, you wash your hands. It can be hand sanitizer, it can be soap and water, anything that you can use to scrub your hands really well. The friction alone helps. And you scrub all over your hands for at least 20 seconds and then run your hands under running water. And that water should wash the virus down the sink. Another important point about coronavirus is that, like a lot of other respiratory viruses, when that person coughs and sneezes, and they don't cover their cough and sneeze, that saliva or whatever's coming out of their nose can land on surfaces, or they can cough into their hand, and their hand could touch surfaces. And the virus can actually live for a number of hours in the saliva, the sputum, that ends up on those surfaces. So it's very important to clean what we call high-touch areas. That would be countertops, door handles, bathroom sink handles, anywhere where somebody who is sick might have touched a hand that was contaminated. And the cleaning agent you use doesn't have to be anything special. Whatever you normally use to clean surfaces, you can go ahead and clean them. And you can clean more often than usual if you're worried that there was somebody sick who was around in your environment. Right. So there's a lot of concern right now. A lot of open gatherings and institutions are being closed. And some of that precaution centers around coronavirus and its ability to hurt people who are older or who have underlying medical conditions, particularly if they have lung diseases like asthma and emphysema. They're at high risk for not doing well with coronavirus. So a lot of gatherings that include older or more sick people, such as nursing homes, a lot of them have been shut down to visitors. A lot of hospitals are starting to restrict visitation. You may want to keep that in mind. You may want to avoid visiting such sites or other, social gatherings where older folks or people who are not well are, just in case that you or somebody around you might have coronavirus or might spread it. You want to prevent spreading it in the community. As far as large gatherings, right now, if it's an outdoor gathering, we're not as worried about it as an indoor gathering, because outdoors folks are spread out more, and if somebody does sneeze or cough in your area, usually they're at least, usually 3 feet from you. Indoor gatherings, when people are very close to each other, is when you have to worry more. For instance, people go on cruise ships, or who are in very tight cubicles, either working or socializing, you could come in contact with people who are sneezing and coughing and might have the infection. Right now, if you don't have symptoms of coronavirus, we're not worried about people spreading it. There's no asymptomatic transmission is the scientific term for that. However, if you start to develop symptoms of coronavirus, we are worried that you might give it to other people. So the symptoms are just like the flu: fever, cough, trouble breathing. The symptoms of coronavirus overlap so much with the flu and other infections, it's very hard to tell what you might have. So it's best to call ahead. If you're gonna go visit your doctor or you're gonna go to the emergency room or urgent care, it's always best to call ahead and make sure that you don't spread it to other people before you come in. For more information, there are great websites that are listed below this video, provided by New York State Department of Health and the CDC, where you can get lots of great information about coronavirus, avoiding it, local numbers. And there's also a great toll-free number that New York State Department of Health has now for any questions you might have about coronavirus, whether you have coronavirus or you're at risk or you're just worried.